Welcome to Using Census Data with Excel. I'm Adam Heckman. Many tables in the census portal have multi-level or hierarchical data. Excel is a great tool to let you visualize that data once you have the data in the proper format. Let's say you want to understand the income gap between males and females with varying levels of education. You can see that we're looking at three separate variables: income, male, and female, and education level. So let's go ahead and search for that data by saying median incomes by sex by educational attainment. And I have my choice here of a few different tables. Let's select this one, median income in $2009 with populations 25 years and over with earnings. So this looks like the right data that I want, and we're going to export this. And instead of exporting it to CSV, we're going to export it directly to Excel. And you'll notice down here, it brings up the file in an Excel format. So here's the data. I'm going to create some hierarchical charts for this. I'm going to have to do some massaging of this data to get it ready for a hierarchical chart. For one thing, I'm going to get rid of some of the data that it brought in that I don't need, like this header information. And I don't want these totals. And I don't need the footer. This leaves me with a simple table. So I have my label and the median incomes. So let's rename these. So gender and median income. Now, we want to experiment with hierarchical charts, but hierarchical charts have a specific set of requirements for how the table has to look. To show this is a true hierarchy, I have to break this down so that males and females are denoted in each one of these education levels. So what I'll do is I'll insert a column. I'll take that gender header and bring it over here and call this education. I'll take male and put it here. Put it here. And we'll take female and put it here. And to make sure that we have gender education pairs, I'll copy that data down and do the same for female. And now I no longer need these totals or subtotals. I can get rid of them. Okay, so let's format this the same way so that it looks nice. And it's always good to actually simply click on Format as Table and make it look nice that way. Okay, your table looks like this. We're almost ready to move this into a hierarchical chart, but what's with those green little triangles here on the upper left-hand corner of each cell? That is Excel's way of saving me from hours of work and frustration later on. What it's telling me is that these are formatted as text, and do I really want to format them as a number? And indeed I do. So now I have my median income represented as a number, and now I'm ready to bring this into a hierarchical chart. So let me select my table, and I'll say insert, recommended charts. And notice down at the bottom here, I have a few different hierarchical chart types. For example, I have a tree map, which represents the data values as the area of a triangle. So I can replace this with a proper name. Tree maps are especially good when you have multiple levels. Right now, I only have two levels, gender and education, and I can visually compare males versus females and see that gap. But when I have even more levels of information, the tree map gets even easier to represent the sub-levels as sub-branches and smaller triangles within the smaller rectangles within the bigger rectangles. Now, this is only one way of showing this data. Another way of showing this data in a hierarchical fashion is what's called the sunburst chart. Sunburst. And what the sunburst chart is it's really, think of this as a donut chart inside a donut chart, each level reflecting the category of information. One level of the donut on the inside is gender. The next outermost layer is the educational level. And the size of the segment represents the median income. And you can experiment with this chart and the way it looks using the various styles and make it look exactly the way you want it.